Say you close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you. You're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally shown.
Let us pray. O God of love, creator of man and woman, bless these sacred moments together. You have ordained marriage as a means of joining two separate creations as one. Only in your presence is such a union complete. Be with us now, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. We are gathered together in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. It is a solemnly unique and treasured moment in life when two people who were once strangers to one another are drawn together by an irresistible attraction so that their souls no longer desire to be divided by space or time. A man sees in a woman his dreams of helpmate, comforter, lover. When a woman finds in a man security, companionship, the lover her heart has been longing for, God has it for. We may be seen. First Corinthians 13 reads, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered and keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. I ask Mike and Alice to participate in the ceremony of marriage. Love is the greatest thing on earth, and the rite of marriage is the oldest rite in the world. It was instituted by God in the beginning. It was adorned and beautified by Christ in Cana of Galilee, and it was commended by the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men. It is a sacred and a holy estate in which we find happiness and contentment, but also into the deepest mystery of experience and the very sacrament of divine love. Those who take the vows of marriage are brought into the closest and the most sacred of human relationships. Their lives are blended into one as the waters of confluent streams, and they share in the joys and sorrows of life together. It's the duty of both to love one another, to cherish one another, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, and to encourage each other to fulfill their mutual purposes. In your life, your character and conduct define Alice's happiness. She has given you the most sacred treasure under heaven, her life and her love. The continuance of those virtues as a husband will ensure her, bless, and keep her heart fastened to yours. Will you vow here, as you have already promised her, that you will be true and loyal, be patient with her in sickness, comfort her in sorrow, love and honor her in all duty and tenderness to live with her and cherish her according to the ordinance of God in the sacred bond of marriage. So answer I will. Alice, in your life, love lies much help and inspiration. We will look to you for cheer, for encouragement, and for confidence. May your life be the inspiration and your love the protection that he will need. When you bow here, as you have already promised him, that you will be patient in adversity, minister to him in affliction, comfort him in sorrow, love and honor him according to the ordinance of God, the sacred bond of marriage, so answer I will. You may now join hands and declare before God and his witnesses and to each other your solemn marriage covenant. I give you Alice, to be my faithful and loving wife. Throughout the remainder of our life together, we will be held in you, loving, honoring, and providing for each other's needs. And I promise to remain faithful to you, to love and care for you as long as the world covers. To be my faithful and loving husband throughout the remainder of our life together, we will be healthy people, loving, honoring, and providing for each other's needs. And I promise to remain faithful to you, love and care for you as long as we both shall live. Mike and Alice will now exchange rings to seal the vows they have made to each other today. The ring is an unbroken circle, which is the emblem of eternity. It is to show how lasting the faith and love you both promise by the giving and receiving of these rings. With these emblems of purity and endless devotion, you are sealing your marriage vows forever. Mike, take Alice by the left hand, slide the ring halfway up, and repeat after me. This ring I give you, Alice, in token of our marriage vows, will ever be a symbol of the unbroken bond of our love. Accept this ring from you, Mike, and I wear it as a sign of my love for you. Alice, if you would take Mike by the left hand, slide his ring halfway up under his finger, and repeat after me. This ring I give you, Mike, in token of our marriage vows, it will ever be a symbol of the unbroken bond of our love. Slide the ring on your finger. Right, repeat after me. I accept this ring from you, Alice. I accept it. And I wear it as a sign of my love for you. I wear it as a sign of my love for you. For as much as you might, and you, Alice, have openly declared your desire to be united in holy matrimony, and have pledged your love and faith in each other before God and these witnesses, I declare you to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give him peace. sir. May kiss the bride. Now it is my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Michael Dunaway.